Keep green and keep on planet clean. Hello everyone, I am Namrata of BCom Semester 4, K1 section, studying in Hansraj Mahila Mahavidyalaya Jalandhar. Today, I am here to present my topic, that is green marketing. But before doing that, I am grateful to our principal ma'am, Dr. Mrs. Ajay Sareen, for his encouragement and support. Also, I would like to acknowledge my special gratitude to Dr. Mrs. Kamaldeep Kaur, head of department of, and also to my mentor, Mrs. Binu Gupta, assistant professor of PG department of commerce and management, for his guidance and support, and for giving me directions to complete my project. Also, I would like to thanks to Almighty God for his blessing showered on me during this project. So, let's welcome to this green world. Today, I am going to discuss all these topics. Let's have a look. So, starting with evolution of green marketing. The term green marketing was first reflected in the seminar that was organized in 1975 by AMA, that is American Marketing Association. This evolution includes three stages: ecological, environmental, and sustainable. First one is ecological. During this first stage, namely ecological, all the activities relating to marketing were concerned with all the problems of environment, their treatment, and the methods of cure. Second one is environmental, that focused on clean technology such as innovation of new eco-friendly products, those products which do not harm environment. This phase was beneficial because it focused on taking care of pollution along with waste issues. Last and third one is sustainable, which aimed as production in order to satisfy and fulfill the needs and wants of today's generation, but keeping in mind the aspirations of tomorrow as well. Now, question arises, what is green marketing in actually is? So, answer to this question is that, as you all know, marketing involves all those activities which fills the gap between buyer and the seller. Marketing refers to all the effective techniques and ways of development of marketing products which do not harm environmental. That kind of marketing leads no negative impact on the physical environment. It aims at enhancing the quality of the environment. Requirements involve all those processes which are compatible with the environment, moreover, which fulfill company's goals along with satisfaction of customers. Next one is green marketing mix, which involves 4 P's: product, price, place, and promotion. First one is product. Seller should focus on producing those products which leads no harmful effect on the environment. It must be eco-friendly. Next one is price. It is a critical factor. Customers will only ready to pay additional value if there is something unique and extra about that product. Price should be reasonable and do not exploit the customers. Next one is place. The choice of place, that is where and when to make that product, which will be easily available to the customers at the convenient places, plays an important role. Last one is promotion. Promotion is the promotion of the product through ads and other mediums should be genuine and real. Promotion should lead positive and interactive impact in the minds of the customers. Now, question arises, why green marketing? Why we choose green marketing? By adopting green marketing techniques, customers will become more concerned about the eco-friendly products. Secondly, it will create growing awareness all over the world as well, which will result in protecting the environment as well. In addition to this, manufacturers have also realized that kind of marketing as a concept a competitive advantage. Government of India also framed rules and regulations to protect the customers and to follow the green marketing. Moving towards next slide relating to 3 R's of environmentalism, which includes reduce, reuse, and recycle. Reduce means we should reduce the amount of waste that left over after the production. Next one is reuse. Reuse stands that we should use again and again. Let us have an example. We can donate the things that we are not using, but other person can use it instead of throwing it away by us. Another example, we can repair the broken things by following reuse method as well. Last and important one is recycle. One must recycle products as much as or she or he can. It is better said by someone that don't be trashy but be recycled. Now, coming to the characteristics of the green product. Green product not always mean that product must be in green color or it should be always packed in green wrapper. No. Green product means product which are eco-friendly, which are recyclable, reusable and biodegradable. Also, it contains approved chemicals and natural ingredients and non-toxic chemicals. In addition to this, green products do not harm the environment and do not pollute the environment. Now, there are some benefits of green marketing. By adopting green marketing, one can earn profitability and long-term growth along with the goodwill among various enterprises in the market. Yes, the initial cost of the setup and all is very high, but it can be useful in saving money in long run. Now, I am going to share some green products of Indian market such as ACC Limited, MRF, HCL, Nerolac, etc. If I talk about ACC Limited, then ACC Limited is the most popular Indian cement company that manufactures cement. ACC Limited launched Concrete Plus brand, which is totally eco-friendly. Now, question arises, how it is eco-friendly? It is eco-friendly in such a way that it uses fly ash to prevent and save the natural resources of the environment. Features of this product is that it ensures high durability and resistance of the structure under extreme conditions. Now, next one is MRF tires. As you know, MRF is tire manufacturing company. In order to conserve environment, MRF has launched a new series of eco-friendly tires, namely ZSLK series. These tires are made from unique silica-based rubber. These type of tires are totally eco-friendly, which offers extra fuel efficiency only those who have ZSLK series tires. Moving towards next slide, which is depicting the steps taken by HCL company. You can see, HCL has also contributed towards environment by launching HCL ME40 notebooks. These kind of notebooks do not use PVC material. Also, it do not include any kind of harmful chemicals. Best part is, Bureau of Energy Efficiency has given 5-star rating to this company. Moving forward to next slide, Nerolac has also contributed towards saving natural resources. It has removed harmful heavy metals from their paint. As you know, lead is harmful substance. Nerolac has worked on removing this because it is dangerous to human beings as it damages the central nervous system, kidneys and reproductive system as well. Children are also prone to lead because it is harmful and leads to memory loss and lower intelligence. There is a concept of greenwashing, which means companies and organizations provide disinformation and mislead the customers by providing them wrong information and adoption of wrong practices. They convey their customers that they are following green marketing practices, but in reality, they are not using and mislead their customers. You can see in this picture that chimneys are creating harmful pollution, but by painting green color outside doesn't mean that they have adopted green marketing practices. They are just misleading their customers for sake of public image only. Coca-Cola company was taking water away from drought-ridden areas and farmlands. Coke open bottling plants were taking all the water away. As a result, farmers were unable to feed their crops and population of that area as well. In order to increase their sales, they were using natural resource, that is water, and depleted the water at that time. This was an example of greenwashing. above case was greenwashing case in case of Coca-Cola company. Many MNCs and other companies earn profit and goodwill by adopting green marketing methods. Famous McDonald's, as you all know, they always pack their burgers and other eatable items in renewable, biodegradable and recyclable paper bags and cardboards instead of using plastic bags. This is really very useful in conserving natural environment and natural resources. So, by concluding this, I can say that buyers and sellers both are aware about green marketing. But still, there is a need of creating awareness in the mind of both about this concept, which will result in saving environment and natural resources as well. Sellers do not adopt greenwashing and other wrongful practices. So, at last but not least, I would like to say that green marketing is catching on a big way. So, go green, go safe. If you have any queries, you can drop in comment section. Thanks for watching this video.